first ever podcast recording inside of our new studio.
It's looking good.
Yeah, it is. I am here with Nelson Mayer.
Yes, hello.
And I say it properly because I have respect for you as a gangster rapper that could potentially pull a gack on me at any moment.
I know. I'm aware that I look like I play bass with suicidal tendencies right now. That's all I see when I look myself. But in my defense, we're doing a podcast. I didn't think of the fact, and you told me so. In all fairness, you told me it was going to be a video. I forgot that part. Yeah. So I figured it's dressed like a douche day. I got the Compton hat. I got a shirt that says laying pipes since 1969. I couldn't be a bigger dick right now. And it's perfect because everybody's going to see that.
Just
so
tell people that it's Ice Cube Day. Yeah, you literally look like Ice Cube used to when he was in NWA.
I'll take that. Yeah.
But now he... I saw something, and it's funny because I don't even have this post, but I saw a post. He's Lord Ice Cube now.
I saw that, yeah.
And he's, like, teaching people how to be a lord?
I don't know. I think he's selling, like, little plots of land in Scotland or something.
Jesus. He went from the hardest rapper on earth to, like, doing kids' films to going back to being the hardest rapper, trying to be the hardest rapper on earth. Now he's the Lord.
He's doing cameo appearances too. You can pay like $100 to get him to say happy birthday to your kid or something.
Cool. I want Ice Cube.
Ice Cube.
My cousin always kind of looked like Ice Cube growing up. So I always equated him to Ice Cube. So I was always scared of him.
Yeah.
But then he's a pussy. So I'm like, it's not that bad.
Without the outfit, I always looked like Cheech growing up. That's what I always got from people.
Oh, that makes sense.
I thought it was great. You had the light shining on me so bright. I look so white, I could probably get a bank loan now. I need to take one of these with me when I go apply next time. Approved. It's awesome.
Okay, so speaking of light, what's with the glasses?
You know,
are you Corey Hart?
I'm not. I swear to God, it's dressed like a douche day. I'm telling you. I have prescription sunglasses that I can find. I have regular glasses that I can't find today. So this is what I had. And again, I thought we're going to be doing a podcast and nobody's going to see what an idiot I look like. But
right, because we did the first one back with the old podcast. It was all audio.
Yeah.
And it was in like a super corporate office
that
we converted into a podcast studio. So this is now a permanent podcast studio.
It looks great. I like it.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a work in progress. Like, we need to get something for this wall. Originally, the shot was supposed to be going this way.
Yeah.
You know, but then we had to work with the room, and then I had to switch cameras. It's a huge pain in the ass.
The paint is so fresh, we are going to get high from the fumes, I think.
Yeah, well, we can get high about other things, too, if you want.
There we go. But just for the occasion.
Yeah, there you go. Just so everybody's familiar, because it's the first one, this is called Shit People Post. And it's basically we're just looking at posts people make and just like talking about them and then going completely off in the weeds and forgetting what we were talking about and getting into a new subject.
So we just make fun of people on Facebook.
A little bit of that, yeah. A little serious, a little funny, okay. you know. So I felt like this, if Ashley, you bring up the first one, I felt like this first one probably embodies you and me in the middle of the night.
Yeah.
Right? Like, this is pretty much, and I actually think about this every morning. I'm like, okay. Or, you know, in the middle of the night, I'm like, I can't. If I get up, I have to maintain my sleepiness.
Yeah.
Right? Do you do that too?
Oh, you know, I'm always up at 4 a.m. anyway. So
okay, that's fair.
I'm still trying to go to bed.
Life. Yeah. Yeah. So what's your, when do you go to sleep then?
I usually try around 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and then I usually end up passing out around 2:30, 3-ish, and then I'm up again at like 5:30. And occasionally I'll be lucky and get a nap in during the day, but now I have my kids full time, so that's not a thing that's been happening lately.
Oh, and you've got like 47?
I have 47 now, yeah. Found them all at the park, so.
And is Clayton getting into comedy?
Well, he's been trying for a long time, but he's never been funny. Clayton is not my son. People say that. It's funny. He's a friend of mine. He's going to love this when he sees
it.
Because he's like the same age as me practically. But I look like I'm 100 years old unless I'm dressed like Ice Cube. And he looks so young. He has such a baby face. A lot of people say that. They'll say, hey, is this your father? And I'm like, fuck you. He's four years younger than me.
I seriously thought he was.
A lot of people do, yeah.
I thought he just graduated high school like 2 years ago.
He looks so young. It's ridiculous. Yeah, he's like 34 years old, 35 years old.
What's going on there?
Shit, he just doesn't move. He doesn't do anything. He's like in a permanent state of just nothingness. So.
And some of the jokes you post about him.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I just, they're exactly what I need in my day most times.
Yeah.
Like, I'm like, this is just great.
Yeah.
This is good material.
We have been friends for longer than you thought he was alive. So it's one of those relationships where I can pick on him as much as I want. And
what's his role in your life besides being friend? Like, is he just your like butt of all jokes?
Yeah. Or? Well, no. I mean, everybody I hang out with is the butt of all my jokes. It's just kind of what I do. I'm a bit of an asshole. I don't know why I have friends. It's crazy. But I've known him since he worked for my father. And my dad had a wrestling federation locally, and they traveled around the province. So Clayton worked for that, doing IT and things like this, social media type stuff. And then of course, I met him through that, didn't talk to him for years, and then I started doing comedy, running shows, and Clayton started working for me as my IT guy and social media guy.
All right.
And then he started doing comedy, so I bring him on the road as my opener a lot. So.
Why didn't you get into wrestling?
Why didn't I get into wrestling? Yeah. I would have loved to have done, like, the bad guy. I'm not a tough guy. I'm going to get my ass smacked. It's not realistic if I'm beating big guys, right?
Right, right.
But I would have loved to have been a bad guy manager, and there's a couple times that my father and I were working on setting that up. I really wanted to just take a bump. I wanted to get slammed by the good guy for me talking trash. You remember the Andy Kaufman wrestling thing? Did you ever see that?
I don't really remember it, but I saw the movie that where Jim Carrey
played him. Yeah.
So
this is what he did in real life. It's ridiculous. It kind of ruined his career. He started wrestling women, and he would play this bad guy villain wrestler, and he would talk trash, and he would say the most outlandishly misogynistic shit, and people really started to hate him. He was doing too good of a job, and he went down to Memphis wrestling, and he challenged Jerry Lawler, and he got body slammed, the whole big thing, just like in the movie. It was all a work that they had done. But I wanted to do that kind of thing where I showed up after being on APTN, like that was the big thing, right, for Aboriginal entertainers. I made it to the top. So I wanted to go to my dad's wrestling federation and show up and be like, my dad's an embarrassment to me. This is such a waste of time. You guys are all idiots. And then have the good guy wrestler come out and, like, body slam me. And I would have took the hit. It would have been great.
Yeah,
but I never never got a chance to make that happen.
I want to get Danny Duggan on, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Because he's got stories.
Oh, I imagine, yeah.
Holy man. That guy's lived wrestling his entire life.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, he's just like, and I don't know, you saw last winter, I think it was last winter, he got in this like horrible car accident where they flipped off the road, went down a mountain or something.
Oh, wow. I didn't see that.
It was crazy. Like, but he lives at CWE wrestling.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's an interesting lifestyle.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, like I was dating a girl that had a son and we went to this wrestling show together and he's only seen WWE wrestling. This was, I think, his first real exposure to live wrestling and on a smaller circuit, right?
Yeah.
And so I know Danny. So I asked a couple of guys, I'm like, you know, could you pop him while you're going
to
the show, right? So just look at him and be like, what are you looking at, you little punk?
Yeah.
You know? And he's just like,
that's
me,
awesome.
Me,
yeah.
You know? It was pretty cool.
Yeah, so. I love that stuff. And I wanted to be that guy so bad. Just come out and be the villain. Even after my father passed away, they did a tag team tournament thing in his honor, and they were going to present a little award to my stepmother and this, and I wanted to go there for that just so I could come out and do the exact same thing, and my dad would have loved it. Doesn't matter if it was a memorial thing for him. I would have come out and said, this is such a stupid waste of time, and my father was the worst human being, and but believe it or not, that would have been a great way to honor my father, is taking a bump by trash talking him after he had died.
I've seen Shane and Vince interact.
It's great. I would have loved that. Yeah.
That family is so dysfunctional. I'll never forget, there was, do you remember when, did you watch WWE back in the day?
Yep.
I guess so.
Yep.
You probably did. When the Ministry of Darkness was and Vince ended up being, and it was like the biggest fail in wrestling history. Everyone's like, what?
Yeah.
Come on. What a waste of time.
I love wrestling. I could talk about that for hours. We're going to go off on a tangent if we go this too far. You're not going to get any more slides.
But you're kind of, you know what? Let's do, this actually applies to you. Let's do another slide, another post. So no matter how good of a person you are, you're the asshole in someone's story. So
it's true.
I picked this one, you know, because I've seen what you've been going through.
Yeah.
And you're like kind of posting stuff about, like, you know, arguments you're getting into.
Oh, yeah. Over. Yeah.
Do you think people have lost their funny bone?
I think a lot of people have, you know, and, the most recent one was somebody had posted a news article about, graffiti on Elvis's wall. There's Black Lives Matter people post graffiti all over Elvis's wall. So I shared that and I said,
the king
of rock and roll, Elvis Presley, the wall outside of Graceland. And they were incensed that somebody would do this, right? And I mean, they're just pissed off that it was Black Lives Matter. They didn't give a shit. And that's what kind of the point of my, it was just a joke mostly. But I was like, come on. Are you serious? Isn't that wall already fucking covered in graffiti? And let's be honest, I think Elvis at least owes this much to black people. Come on.
That's a good quality joke.
People lost their minds on my page, and I just thought, holy shit. I mean, number one, it was a joke. And yes, I was basing it on my own opinion, which is, you know, fuck that. I mean, I love Elvis. I really do. But fuck him. He was a bit of a racist in his time, and he stole rock and roll. He stole it. Come on.
He stole
a lot from black people. So and what it is what it is, but I posted my joke. And don't bitch about the graffiti on the wall being a disgusting disgrace, because you're just mad because it was Black Lives Matter. That's what it was. If somebody posted anything else, because it's not all tributes to the king on that wall. I've been to the wall. It says Karen sucks a good dick. Like, it says all kinds of screwed up shit on that wall. Oh, people write whatever
That's
on the
amazing.
Wall, right? I've
it.
Seen it. I mean, I'm like, I've been there four times.
Karen.
So, Karen, I know. It's terrible.
Yeah.
So, but I think people were just pissed off for the most part because it was specifically Black Lives Matter. And maybe they weren't. Maybe they're really upset that graffiti is a thing. I don't know. That's up to them.
Maybe they should look in their own backyard before
we're in Winnipeg. Come on, there's graffiti on everything.
Like, literally the nicest bridge in the city, and, like, every week they're out there scrubbing graffiti off of it, you know? It's like, protect the children. This is the way to put out the message?
Yeah.
I don't know. You also spelled protect wrong.
Yeah,
so
I love that one.
I wanted to get a picture of that so bad. I went to Taco Time. It's Ashley's favorite restaurant, our producer, Ashley.
Yep.
And came back, and I was like, hey, I'm going to get the picture. And then I was like, fuck, the traffic was being stupid.
Oh, yeah.
I couldn't get it. The next day I went back and it was
gone. Yeah.
But I love when you have like a social message that you can't spell right.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
It's key. It's key to the cause.
Absolutely.
So I guess, because I've noticed, I mean, we talked about last time. I mean, if anybody wants to go back and archive episodes, you can. But we talked about last time about, you know, I had some jokes I got in trouble for at one point. And do you think... like, it feels to me, you're a comedian, so you know it's better. Do you think it's getting worse? Do you think it's like the backlash comedians are getting? Like, do you think Anthony Jeselnik will be able to tell jokes in 2021?
I think certain people will, right? Once you have that fan base, and if you're clever enough and brilliant enough, you can still do this. It just depends on the message. The problem is you got a lot of people that are idiots that are full of actual hate, or they're just stupid and they don't know any better and they're just trying to shock for the sake of shocking. And they use guys like Bill Burr and Richard Pryor and these classic great comedians as an example of what they're trying to do. Well, you're not actually doing that. You're a fucking idiot. These guys are brilliant. It's not the same thing when you talk about, you know, fucking raping children and fetuses and stupid shit like that. I've heard this crap on stage in clubs. I'm serious. And then what Bill Burr is doing, or, you know, somebody like Dave Chappelle, whether you like him or not, he can say things in kind of a brilliant way. Whether you agree with him or not, he's trying to be clever. He's trying to share his opinion. These other guys are just doing it to shock. And that's the problem, because they start saying free speech and they start going anti-woke this, anti-woke that. You know, it's not always about that. I have friends of mine that identify as very woke. I am not. I try to be, and I think I'm pretty respectful, but I'm not exactly that. I think funny is funny. If you can do it in a clever way, go for it. But if you're just out there trying to shock people, I think that shit's weak. And there's still a lot of that. So I wouldn't defend that kind of comedy.
Right.
I think it's okay. Here's the thing. The cancel culture that they talk about, it's hard for me to talk about it because it's not that I don't completely agree with it or completely disagree with it. There are people that fucking absolutely need to be canceled. They're pieces of shit. And when you find out that they're pieces of shit, we shouldn't support them at all. And then other times I think we go too far. I got in trouble with this over a local DJ who was recently reinstated back on the air.
Oh, yeah,
and I shared my opinion because I know that guy.
I saw that, yeah.
I know that guy. Yeah. I know him. And, you know, maybe I don't know him completely. Maybe he's a racist piece of shit behind closed doors. I don't know that. But I don't think what I've seen indicates that this person's a racist, and things that they've done whilst being stupid, I don't think you can judge somebody based on one or two things. I look at my Facebook, like, on this day in history shit. Fuck. I would cancel myself on a daily basis for the stupid shit I used
to
post.
Your Facebook is crazy.
You know? But it's gotten better, I think. I think I'm a little smarter with the kind of stuff I post.
I liked it when it was crazier, though.
Yeah.
Like, but you're right. It's very hard to tell those types of jokes.
And I think I still do it. So I think I still have some people that delete me and they don't even say goodbye. They're just gone one day. Something I say goes too far. But there are stuff that I've looked at in the past where I think, what the hell? That's not even funny. That's terrible. That's disgusting. Why would I have thought that was funny? But that's not who I was even back then. It's just the sense of humor that I thought was okay, right?
Right.
So, and I think people change and people grow and you have to allow that. And I think when we're shutting people down instantly and canceling them over something stupid they've done, I think not everybody
like
that says a racist
ago.
Joke is a racist.
Yeah.
That's what I'm going to say. And I'll own that to anybody that wants to debate it. Just because you say a racist joke doesn't mean you're racist.
Yeah, I mean, especially, you know, they keep bringing up, they love to do this with politicians. They'll be like, well, back in 1974, he was anti-gay. Back in 1974, almost everybody was anti-gay.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you're allowed to evolve your opinion,
exactly,
your thought process
and
all that, and become a smarter human and a better human.
Yeah, and the thing that frightens me about
you're not actually allowed.
Not
it doesn't seem
like
you
days.
Can anymore.
And here's what frightens me about that, because when you shut down dialogue, let's say that you have ignorant ideas, or I think they're ignorant, and, you know, I tell you, you're a piece of shit, you're transphobic, you're homophobic, you're a piece of shit, and we should shut you down and never hear from you again. You're not waking up and realizing, shit, maybe they're right. You're going away and you're saying, fuck those guys, they're assholes. And you're going to find like-minded people who will support your maybe warped view, and that will grow. And then you have underground movements like the KKK and shit like that that develop. Yeah. Meanwhile, you're missing an opportunity to sit down with somebody and explain your point of view, and maybe you walk away with, and they have a better understanding, right? Because yeah. I've said ignorant things in the past that I didn't understand, and I am now more aware of them, right? Because somebody had a dialogue with me, and I was open to sit there and listen. But when you wave a finger at somebody and say, you're a piece of shit because you said this thing,
yeah.
or you shared this joke, or you did this or that, there's no opportunity for learning. There's no opportunity for education. So I think it's more important to say, hey, this is why I think you're wrong. You're not a piece of shit. Maybe you think something that I think is warped. Doesn't necessarily make me fucking right either, by the way.
Right, yeah.
Let's have that dialogue, right?
Yeah. Well, I'm having one of the episodes coming up is going to be with the guy that leads the Freedom Fighter rallies in Winnipeg.
Yeah.
Now, I'm totally on the opposite end. And when I messaged him on Facebook, I was like, here's the deal.
Yeah.
I'm totally opposite of what you believe, mm-hmm. but I think that there are people that are on the fence that don't have the info that we could have a good dialogue and we could
yeah.
actually, like, you know, make them think a bit mm-hmm. about what they're, you know, where they should maybe sit on this whole thing.
Yeah.
You know, and he was like, oh, that's interesting. You know,
yeah.
like, it's,
yeah.
because usually it's you're on one side or you're on the other.
Exactly.
And they
yeah.
do not talk.
Yeah.
And I think that that's probably the biggest fault that we have in
yeah.
2020 is that, like, COVID and Trump and mm-hmm. like everything going on has just split the world down the middle.
Oh yeah, I love seeing on people's page, if you believe this or if you support this, unfriend me now.
Yeah, yeah, I get seriously, I see those all the time.
That's maybe one part of who I am, really.
If you find there was a post I saw one time, and a guy said, you know, I gotta save more posts. But this one guy was like, he said, if you have ever told a joke that involved a race, unfriend me.
Yeah.
So I was like,
if you've ever done that, okay.
I'm currently unfriending you.
Yeah.
Because, you know, like, it's, you can, there, you can tell jokes about taboo subjects without being an asshole.
Yeah.
Like you were saying before. And I think you dip your toe in the asshole pool,
mm-hmm.
but you don't dive in and cannibal.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Like, you could be, people have to realize, like, you're not dropping jokes that are actually meant to be offensive. You're dropping jokes that are made to, like, make fun of the current climate.
Yeah, yeah,
you know?
Absolutely.
So, and I just, it drives me nuts when I see, because I had a friend message me, like, isn't this the guy you had on the, because you were on the Winnipeg show first. That's
yep.
when we met.
That's right, yeah.
It was our old TV show. And then we did the showcast last
yeah.
time, and now we're here. And I remember we had your kind of like X-rated version of what you did on the
oh yes
the rated
yeah.
R version of
yeah.
what you did on Winnipeg show, and I put that online.
Yeah.
And someone was like, and this is when the heck was that show? That was 2011.
Yeah, probably.
Say.
Yeah.
Holy shit, we know each other for
that's
9 years.
Crazy.
But this, I get the video shared to my inbox, right?
Yeah.
And this woman was like, if you support this guy, I don't support you. And I was like, what don't you like? And she's like, just the way he talks. He tries to get girls to show their boobs. And I was like,
oh, that joke? That's so
innocuous. I was like, here's the deal. In case you're not aware,
yeah.
most guys want to see your boobs.
It's true. Yeah.
Just the way it is. We're built with testosterone. It's kind of, now, there's a guy like you and me that
yeah.
are going to be respectful.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
not
yeah.
try to grab him by the pussy.
Well, exactly, yeah.
So to speak. But then there's other guys that are jerks.
Yeah.
And, like, you're not saying, you're not, you didn't say that joke so that you can see boobs. You said that joke to, like, get that moment of pause. Where it's
yeah.
like, oh, I'm going to, oh,
yeah.
oh, what the fuck?
You and know? I think the actual point of that whole joke, like, behind it is just me being a piece of shit, like, downplaying the role that women have in childbirth, which really, I mean, we do nothing as men. We're useless. I've never felt more useless than sitting there watch my ex give birth, like, while I'm handing ice chips, like, hey, don't worry, honey, I got the ice chip fucking game covered. No, I got this shit. You don't worry about it, you know? Like, you're useless. You're a useless piece of shit. But in the joke, I'm kind of like, oh, it's no big deal going through. Like, that's the whole point, is just me being a bit of an asshole and downplaying what women actually go through, which is fucking incredible. And then the end
yeah.
is just like, let's vote on who should have to go get fixed, right? So it's just a stupid, that is just a stupid little tag at the end.
I'm yeah, yeah.
surprised somebody would be offended. I've said so many more
oh, yeah,
way offensive things than that.
Yeah, she was just stuck on that one point.
Okay.
I was like, well, I mean, you're allowed to think whatever you
yeah,
want to think,
yeah.
but I mean, Jesus, like, put
yeah,
some context into
yeah.
this stuff.
Pick your battles.
On that childbirth thing, mm-hmm. how many kids do you actually have?
I have six kids.
You have six kids.
Five that I made, and one is my niece I've been raising since she was 2 years old.
Oh, okay. And so six more than I have. So I wasn't really exposed to the whole, you know,
oh, yeah.
birth thing for
yeah.
the longest time. And then my friend had a kid, and the dad flew the coop. Oh, okay. So I was like kind of de facto, you know, oh, okay, law's yeah. class yep. guy and everything.
Oh, yeah.
Holy shit, we're lucky to be yeah. men.
Wow. Were you like in the delivery room? Did yeah, you go that man. Far? Oh, shit, yeah.
I did the whole thing.
Yeah.
And I was like, this is like, you're literally going to change everything about you once this happens.
Yeah.
You know, like, she was very much a very petite girl, and like, mm-hmm. she's like, and now she's dealing with the stretch marks and what comes with that psychologically yeah. and all that. And just like but the process of the whole
yeah.
thing is
no,
just
nuts.
Like, man, I'm like, she's, you know, breathing exercises, dealing with like, what are those pains called? The, do you know what those pains
contractions?
Are called? No, the, when they're fake contractions, they're
Braxton
like,
Hicks.
Braxton Hicks.
Yeah, yeah.
She's dealing with Braxton Hicks.
Yeah.
And I'm sitting at home watching Smallville and yeah, eating yeah. chips, you know? Like, yeah. and like, man, it's just such a.
Yeah.
Guys, we don't get it sometimes.
Oh, yeah. And I watch that and think of what a baby I am when I have a cold. And I'm like, shit. Yeah, I stub my like, toe and I want somebody to carry me to the sofa. And
yeah.
She's
absolutely.
Shooting babies out of her vagina. Are you kidding me?
Yeah. You know what's funny, actually? I tore my quad off my abductor a couple weeks ago.
Oh, yeah.
And I was hobbling along and I went out to lunch with a friend and I hobble into the restaurant. And like every step I take, I'm like,
yeah.
You know, and I get to the table and she's like, what's wrong with you? I'm like, I tore my quad. She's like, God, the way you're going on, it's where you're giving birth
yeah,
over there.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh, shit.
Yep, I burnt my arm this cold. Morning. I don't know if you can see that. I burnt my arm a little bit here somewhere
oh, yeah,
yeah. On the oven. And I sent my mom a message right away. Mom, I hurt myself. Provide me with sympathy. You know, it's crazy. The childbirth thing, I'm going to go back to that because we were talking about it, so why not? Mm-hmm. And women with stretch marks. You know, it drives me nuts. How much pressure we've put on women that they feel ashamed. I got stretch marks because of fucking cheeseburgers, right? And I'll walk around the beach with my big floppy bologna tits hanging out like I'm God's
bowling
gift, right? Bologna tits.
Oh, bologna tits.
Just
like,
flopping away.
I heard this
yeah.
bowling tits thing.
But yet, you know, women go through this. Like they really have. I've seen those posts, you know, you've earned them, you're a tiger with a stripe. That shit's true, man.
Yeah, man.
You know, watching what women go through, it's incredible. But I think it's, see, here's where my comedy might confuse people because on stage I will say, I think it's great that we absolutely destroy women's self-esteem and make them feel bad about their bodies. And then I switch it and I say, because that's the only way they put up with the stupid shit we do as men, right?
Yeah.
So now depending on how you're listening to that joke, you can be like, what an asshole that guy is. But I'm really, that's just the joke to set up the fact that we're pieces of shit. We don't deserve women. What the hell do we do to deserve women? You go on a date, a woman like does her hair, does her makeup, does all this shit, and sometimes we can barely be bothered to wash our nuts properly. Like, are you serious? We don't deserve women.
No,
other dudes. I don't know, whatever.
You know, it's funny because I've got a core group of friends, right? We go to Sal's.
Yeah.
And we, you know, late night Sal's and eat. Well, not right now, but usually.
Yeah.
And we're sitting around talking about one of my buddies, you know, perfect hair. You know, he's got great skin. He's like, he always looks good, right?
Yeah. I have no idea what perfect hair is. I don't know.
Oh, wow. There you are. Whoa, crazy.
And it's the Compton hat.
Yeah, no doubt. So, you know, my buddies are making fun of him, right?
Yeah.
And he dropped a line. This is like 10 years ago, and I never forgot it. And it totally changed everything about the way I act in a relationship. He's like, I see what my girl goes through to look good for me.
Yeah.
I'm going to return the favor.
Yeah.
And I was like, holy shit, that's a revelation
yeah,
right there,
yeah.
you know? And I've been doing it ever since. Well, yeah. I mean, as much as I can.
Yeah.
But, you know, he's naturally pretty gifted when it comes to, you know, like, girls look at him and they're like, oh, my God, is that Brad Pitt?
Yeah.
You know, they look at me and they're like, is that ugly guy from X-Files? You
yeah,
know?
Yeah.
And not David Duchovny.
Well, I'm going to rock this because you said I look like Ice Cube, and that's the best I'm getting for a long time. So I'll keep rocking it.
Yeah, do it.
Why not?
There's nothing wrong with that. Let's go to another post that's Nelson-related, I think. I like this one. So I don't know if you've seen this. So this is Christian Bale talking about, if you have a problem with me, call me. If you don't have my number, then that means, oh, we're zoomed in. Zoom out of it. Can you? You can't zoom out anymore? Okay. Yeah. Oh, there you go. Yeah. If you don't have my number, that means you don't know me well enough to have a problem. So I think that relates. How does that relate to a local comedian? So, because, I mean, you're, sorry, I shouldn't call you a local, because you do tour, you do all that stuff.
I did, yeah, now we're all out of work, and now I just shoplift, that's all I do. There's no more comedy shows. I had a tour set up before COVID hit, my first, like, real headlining tour. We're doing a Western Manitoba thing. We had 7 dates set up, 5 of the shows were sold out, and then fucking COVID hit, and everything got canceled, so.
I you want to hear the worst timing ever? I started travel blogging in February.
Oh, shit.
I was literally in Idaho Falls on my way to do 12 cities.
Oh, man.
And then Justin came on TV and said, get back to
go
Canada.
Home. Yeah. Say your travel blog is, I went to Windsor Park today.
Pretty much, yeah. Exactly.
You know, I've had problems in the past with local comedians. It's funny because I don't like text conversations and I don't like Facebook Messenger, and I want to meet face to face if somebody wants to discuss something with me. But I realized after telling this guy, you know, if you have a problem with me, we can meet in public. It sounds like I'm challenging you to. I wasn't challenging him to a fight. I'm
you're
just
Ice Cube.
If you
so
want to talk to me,
win.
We'll fucking meet anytime, any place. Like, poor choice of words. You say anytime, any place. Yeah, people are like, look, I'm not here to fight. Well, neither am I. I just want to have a dialogue face to face. It's my preference. So people have done that in the past with me. I haven't had any problems for a long time, but I don't run shows locally. I don't get involved in the scene in Winnipeg anymore. Okay. Other than the After Dark TV show that I'm trying to film, throw my own plug on there. Check it out. There's one episode and maybe more coming if Clayton ever edits them.
So, it was Clayton that was the problem.
Clayton's,
I thought it was
not,
Mark that was the...
No. Okay. Mark's the gopher.
Oh, yeah. Mark's the gopher.
Mark's
got
the gopher.
Okay.
Clayton's the co-host / editor. All you got to do is edit the damn show, and he's just taking forever.
Where can they watch you After Dark again?
What's that?
Where can they watch the show?
Right now, a single show? There's a... I think we have a YouTube channel. This is Clayton's stuff. I don't know anything about it. I know he posts it, and I find it on there. It's on YouTube somewhere, After Dark. Search for that and my name, and probably something will come up. There's one episode. And it's funny, because the first episode... I look visibly angry during our open monologue because I got mad at Clayton the night before and I quit. I told him, fuck yourself, do the show by yourself, you piece of shit. And it was because of how long he was taking to edit something. And then I came out begrudgingly and I did the show, and I'm watching it later. I'm like, holy shit, I just look mad. I look so upset. But it was overall a good show. The second episode was much better, and one day it'll come out. I don't know. But back to that quote we're supposed to talk about.
Yeah.
I love that. That makes perfect sense to me, right? Like, you don't know me well enough to have my number. What the hell is your issue with me? I shouldn't be concerning you that much. And that's a lesson I try to teach my kids, right? Like, somebody's like picking on me at school. Well, who's doing that? This kid. Is that kid your friend? No. Well, then what do you care if that kid's an asshole?
Yeah.
Who cares if they called you fat, stupid, lazy, whatever they called you? Are you really going to let an asshole's opinion of you affect you that much? And that's kind of like the important lesson that
message.
I think for everybody, right?
Yeah.
If I'm bothering you because I'm an idiot or you don't have any time for me, fucking delete me. Big deal.
Well, social media is a total dumpster fire. Have you looked at my Facebook lately?
Ridiculous. I've seen you've had a couple battles on there yourself. Yeah.
Holy man, because I'm trying my best to like understand COVID and all that and try to put out the... I subscribe to scientific and medical journals and everything, and I just got into a HST, Health Sciences and Technology
course.
Yeah, so I'm like, I'm really trying to understand it and kind of like cut through the bullshit.
Yeah.
But man, and it's crazy how every time I post about COVID, somebody brings up Trump.
Yeah.
Like,
oh,
Trump 2020. I'm like, what the fuck does that have to do with the fact that if you get a dosage of COVID, a small dosage, you will be asymptomatic. If you get a large dose of it, you will maybe die.
Yeah.
You know, Trump is nowhere in this. I don't understand why we have to make everything about Trump all the time.
I think I saw one of your posts where you're explaining that you've been researching this and reading about it, and somebody in the comments posts along the lines of, I don't know, I didn't see your medical degree on this. And I'm actively telling you that I'm trying to learn this shit right now.
And just for the record, hopefully if I can finish my course and I'm not too dumb to get through it, this is the whole point because of those people.
Yeah.
That happens to me all the time.
Yeah.
They're like, oh, I don't see your medical degree. I'm like, then fuck you. I'm going to go get a medical degree. And then you can, and then when you say that, I'll post it.
There you go.
You know, like that's kind of, you know, I'm just so tired of people just, you know, but everybody is level even now. Like, Neil deGrasse Tyson is like probably the most famous physicist in the world. And Karen in Windsor Park, I don't know why we're picking Windsor Park so much, she has an opinion about physics.
Sure, yeah.
And somehow they're equal.
Well,
now.
She got her information from Uncle Bob's Truth blog, so it must be real. I got these people on my Facebook too. It drives me nuts. And it's both sides. It really is. I kind of feel like I'm in the middle. I have my face mask and I wear it publicly and I don't know how much it works, but I'm going to wear it just in case. Also, I'm type 2 diabetic, so apparently it's more important for me to wear it.
Yeah, for sure.
I don't know enough to say, hey, fuck the masks. And I'm not going to go to any protest that says we need to start hugging people more often, because I feel like right now, you know, I see my grandkids and I fist bump them, you know, because I don't know. And I'm not going to take the chance. Why would I put anybody at risk?
And that's a sensible position to have. So because I'm probably going to say this on 1,000 episodes of this show.
Yeah.
But the reason the face mask work is because COVID matters in dosages. So I kind of try to say this like the sun. You go out in the sun for 15, 20 minutes, you might get a light tan.
Mm-hmm.
You go out in the sun for a couple hours, you might get a burn.
Yeah.
You go sit in the sun for 4 days in Hawaii, you're going to get boils.
Yeah.
Right? So that's how COVID works. And they didn't know that in the beginning, right? Mm-hmm. So they locked down so that they could figure it out.
Yeah.
Because they were worried that we were all going to die, legitimately. Mm-hmm. It was a legitimate concern. But the masks end up being the biggest line of defense, because if I've got a mask, you got a mask, we might get, you might, and let's say I had COVID, you might get 1% of my COVID.
Yeah.
You know, and that you're not even going to probably have a symptom because of it. You'll get it, but you won't have a symptom.
Mm-hmm.
But if we don't have masks on, mm-hmm. you're getting 100% of mine to COVID.
Yeah, yeah.
And you're probably, we're probably going to be, you know, roommates in the hospital, right? Until they put us on ventilators. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like, it's just the science is so clear now.
Yeah.
But yet people still want to deny it. For
and people share
the
most ridiculous shit. They'll find some article that you can see is just some bullshit. You know, it's not a real medical background pamphlet or paper or whatever, but they're sharing it as this is fact, this is gospel. It says right here, masks don't work. Okay, where's your source? Check your source on this. I saw one person share this thing. I can't remember. I don't follow this stuff enough, but it was quoting some mask manufacturer, and he said, their website themselves says these don't work. So I went to their actual website and saw that they said they work.
That's the crazy thing. You can edit anything, and people just share it.
Yeah.
I could edit a picture that, like, just, you know, has like 15 different lies on it.
Yeah.
And nobody bothers to go. Like, I guess a few people do. I did the exact same thing. I saw the exact same post. I went to the website, saw it. It says that it works just fine. But people will Photoshop anything,
mm-hmm.
throw it on the internet, and thousands, just run tens, hundreds of thousands, sometimes millions of people will share it. And it's like, you know, and that as we keep going with this show, I'm going to get into those more, like, crazy posts, you know? But, yeah, it just gets to the point where I'm going, you really have no time. You have time to look at a headline, but you have no time to research it. Then why are you fucking chiming in?
Yeah.
Like, you literally have no data to go off of. That's the thing that drives me crazy. Like, if you go start a new job, right, and your boss says, let's say you start a job at McDonald's, because probably this is, you know, it's a good comparison. There's a lot to that job. People don't realize how much you have to learn to work at McDonald's.
Yep.
But let's say you get hired by the manager, and he says, you want to start right now? And you're like, oh, yeah, I need the money. And he says, okay, go make burgers. Well, are you going to show me how to use equipment? No, fuck you.
Yeah.
Learn on the job.
That's right.
You know, you would be like, there's no way I'm going to do this job. I can't go in the kitchen. I'm probably going to burn myself or somebody else. Yep. I'm going to serve raw meat. You just wouldn't do it.
Yeah.
But yet these people are like, they see a post. It's like, oh, masks don't work. Okay, I'm going to share that despite not researching it at all.
Yeah.
It drives me crazy.
Yeah.
And then they'll fight about it too. Like, they'll go, no, it says right here, black and white. Learn how to read, piece of shit, you fucking douchebag. I'm like, what?
You sheeple need to wake up.
Oh, I love the sheeple. You know what? That's what I should get back here. I should get a giant stuffed sheep.
That's perfect.
A sheep? Yeah. Sheep is plural or singular?
I think maybe you would need
plural. What is a singular sheep?
Shep.
It's the same thing?
Okay.
Sheep is single and, oh, that's
so good. It's not sheep is.
So let's get a sheeps. 6 foot. Ashley, if you could look for a 6 foot sheep. I'm on it. Back here. Yeah. Oh, Serta. I bet you Serta's got some.
Probably, yeah.
You have a little one? Bring it. God, we're going to put him next to Iron Man tomorrow. Oh, that's perfect because we're doing the podcast right with the Freedom Fighter. So that's perfect. You got with the mattress? Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. Libtard and sheeple. Those are the most
common
ones.
Yeah. I love when people call me a libtard because I've worked on 50% of my work in politics has been conservative and 50% has been liberal.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm not either.
Yeah. Yeah.
I go with who has good ideas at the time, at least I think.
Yeah.
Like, the sole reason I worked for Trudeau was because of weed.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's a social, it's a criminal, it's a, you know, it's like, it's an economic issue. Like, it covers all the bases.
Yeah.
Now, like, he completely dropped the ball. And, like, we got shit weed in these stores.
Yeah.
You know, like, what am I going to do with 22% THC? Like, get the fuck out of here. I'm 6'4", I'm 220 pounds. I need the 89%, you know?
Right.
But yeah, so, like, the rollout sucked, but it's a step in the right direction.
Yep.
Right? So, I don't know. But I also worked for Harper.
Yeah.
Scared the shit out of me, but I did. So, yeah, I don't know. I think that people just get too... They get stuck, very tribal, very stuck on one side of things. And even if you show them irrefutable evidence, they'll say, Well, you just made it up.
I think that means you're racist now. I'm supposed to call you racist because you work for Harper. So.
Oh, okay. Fair enough, yeah. But I also work for the number one feminist in this world. Mm-hmm. Let's face it, Justin Trudeau's basically a chick.
Yeah.
So, you know, I guess I'm a racist feminist.
I'm not going to make a blackface joke about Justin Trudeau. I'm not going to do it. Let that go. Do you recall, did you see in the local news not too long ago, there was a student running for University of Winnipeg politics, and there was an issue that he was wearing blackface, and he had run for the Liberal Party at some point in the past as well. Did you see? This was a thing that was blowing up all over social media. It got picked up by the Globe and Mail, and it was run in standard media.
Can you look that up, Ashley? I know I didn't really give you the crash course on that kind of stuff. But
Liberal blackface. I bring it up because you talk about cancel culture. This kid got canceled hard. And the crazy thing is, this was my...
Oh, here we go. Student who ran for Manitoba Liberals.
This is going to get me in trouble. Yeah, there he is.
Yeah, bring it up on the screen so the people can see it.
Yeah.
All right. So that's him?
That's him. And you can't see in this picture because they cut it out. But to the left of him is dressed in blue... was my daughter, because that was her boyfriend at the time.
Oh, no.
And to the left of him is me, dressed up as the Minnesota dentist that shot the lion.
Oh,
that year,
God.
We had this stupid idea for Halloween that we were going to dress up as controversial headlines. He decided to be Bill Cosby. He said, I should put on blackface. My daughter and I said, no, you should not. Do not
no
do
shit.
That. That is stupid.
Keep it on the screen.
My ex said, oh, that's brilliant. That's hilarious. You should do that. So they did it, and... I think at the end of the night, we all realized what a stupid idea this was. This was terrible. The picture resurfaces years later, because this is about 5-6 years ago, and people just canceled him because of what he had done, and he was trying to get into politics. But that's one of the people that were posting is like, we should be calling out the people in the other picture, in the rest of the picture. And
right.
I thought, call me out if you want. I mean, I'm an unemployed comedian. You're not going to get me fucking canceled from anywhere. And this is where my whole train of thought on this kind of was kickstarted. Like, but I've already moved past that. I've realized... Very shortly after that, it was really stupid to do that. We were just trying to shock people, and we dressed as controversial news headlines. So at the time, it was the Minnesota dentist and Bill Cosby and all the shit.
But to be fair, it's Halloween.
Yeah.
And Halloween is a time where, okay, we're going to step way into the weeds here. But I think when you're, I don't know, like, I love Halloween. Mm-hmm. I built a whole event around Halloween. My whole life revolves around Halloween.
Yep.
So I see, you know, the controversy, like if somebody buys a Native American costume and they wear it, right? And it's like people freak out about that, and I'm like, I don't know, like and you probably have you're much more equipped to deal with this, but I'm kind of like, I think like if I were to personally. Let's say there was a movie that had a Native American actor. Oh, you know what? I did.
Mm-hmm.
I actually did. I went which hero was he? Adam Beach in Suicide Squad.
Oh, okay, yeah. Deadeye shot.
No, he wasn't Deadshot. That was Will Smith.
No, yeah.
Oh, why am I forgetting? I'm forgetting. But anyways, I went as him because he was like, totally underutilized in the movie, and everybody that year was going as either Harley Quinn, Joker, or Deadshot.
Yeah.
So I was like, I'm going to go as the guy that nobody paid attention to.
Yeah.
I think it'd be funny. And then I got torn to shreds for dressing up as an Aboriginal. I'm like,
but it's not an Aboriginal character.
And I'm like, and he's a great actor, and he should have been used more.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. As an Aboriginal, we were very pumped and excited and hyped for Adam Beach to be involved in this huge Hollywood production.
Yeah.
And we went to the theater charged, and then we get him on screen, and the fuck, he's dead 2 minutes later. Yeah. What the hell? But, I mean, hey, great on Adam Beach for making it and getting in there. That's great. I'm not offended by costumes of Aboriginal. Like, if you were dressed up... If you put on a costume, you're walking around with a fucking six-pack of beer and saying, hey, look, I'm a fucking drunken Indian. You're a piece of shit.
That's a piece of shit.
But if you're dressing
that's the line.
Up, like, I mean, my opinion differs from a lot of my friends on this one, but I really don't see it automatically as offensive. I don't. Blackface? Fucking, absolutely. That was stupid. Should not have done that at all. It was bad enough dressing up as Bill Cosby.
But was it stupid then, or is it stupid now?
It was stupid then.
I
think, because we
can't remember what the headlines were like around that time.
You know what it is? Because Bill Cosby, we knew he was being accused of these horrific crimes, sexually assaulting, raping women, and we dressed this up to play it for a shocking laugh, right? Which is, I mean, I struggle with this kind of shit, because when you're using humor like that, you've run the risk of victimizing people. And I don't like that shit. I don't want to be on stage telling rape jokes without even considering the fact that there are women in the audience who have been raped.
Yeah, that's
so
fair.
I've learned from that part, right? I'm not perfect. I still make mistakes. I was in that damn picture dressed up like as the Minnesota dentist, standing beside a person dressed up like Bill Cosby, thinking it was funny at the time. Later on, I'm like, well, no, this was fucking terrible what we did.
Yeah.
It was a stupid idea, whatever. But I don't think it's something that you say, oh, you're forever a piece of shit now. You made a mistake. You did something dumb.
That's what I was getting at. So you have a momentary, I mean, you know, that I think that's where everybody gets in trouble with politicians, too, is everybody expects everybody to be perfect all the time.
Mm-hmm.
We're humans. We're going to make endless mistakes.
Yeah.
I know I probably 2-3 times a day make some stupid mistake in my life, you know?
Yeah.
And you know, holding stuff against people. Like, I remember there was a guy, so I was bullied pretty heavily in junior high. And I ran into him later on down the road at a club I was running. And I went to frame this, in grade seven, I had to move out to the country. I went to a school and everything was hockey and cowboy boots.
Mm-hmm.
I was basketball, football, and hip hop. Right. Yeah. So I came in and everybody hated me, instantaneously hated me, you know, and what didn't help that. I got all my cousins' hand-me-downs, and I was wearing cross colors and 42 waist, big baggy blue, bright blue jeans. One of my first days, but so you know, I end up having to deal with a lot of that stuff. I got beat up a lot because you know, thrown off of bridges and things because I was a hip hop kid. And then later on, I saw one of my like major bullies at a club, and he was like, "Oh, you were just ahead of your time," you know. I didn't punch him in the face and you know, crack his nose.
Yeah,
I said to him, I was like, yeah, you were a piece of shit to me, but obviously you're not that big of a piece of shit anymore, so let's have a drink.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know why we can't do that as a functioning society anymore.
Yeah. All right, and even when people haven't moved past it yet, that's my whole point is, you know, I had a guy that showed up to my open mic when I used to run it at the Forks, and he got up on stage and he dropped a hard N-bomb and he dressed like he walked right out of American History X, right? Totally. So I cut his mic. I would allow people to say racial shit on stage, but if there was a feeling that there was actual hatred behind it, I would cut it.
Right.
And this guy, he and I ended up talking. I banned him from my open mic for a couple weeks, and we talked about it, and he genuinely was a white supremacist.
Oh, shit.
He genuinely was. But I let him come back under the understanding that that shit wasn't going to be allowed on my stage, and he and I had some great conversations. Now, I don't know if I ever changed his opinion about minorities. I don't know that. But I know that he and I had some good, respectful conversations. So you can have that with anybody. And if you just shut people down, if I said, you're a piece of shit, get the fuck out of here, all he's going to do is leave thinking, I'm right, those fucking damn
Indians,
whatever,
right?
Yeah. And not that you need to. Like, if sometimes you need to say, get the fuck out of here, I have no time for you. And I don't suggest that anybody should have patience with these people just because I do.
Right.
But I am not going to shut people down based on one small part of them.
Yeah.
Unless I feel it's warranted, like a child molester, a rapist, something like that.
There's the big four that I can't get past. There's the rapists, the pedophiles, the murderers, and the people that intentionally, they live their lives to victimize people.
Yeah. Yep.
Those four people can go fuck themselves. Yep. I really wish we could turn Antarctica into like a place we just drop assholes off on, you know? This is where you go. This is where you live.
Sure.
There's some bears in the corner you can try to kill if they don't kill you first.
I mean, sometimes that works out. Isn't that how Australia came about?
But Australia's too nice. You know? We don't want to give them a nice place.
I mean, that's,
You know, because maybe a decade on Antarctica of enough fight bears for your food, maybe that might make you realize that maybe those guys aren't so bad. You know, I don't know. It's hard.
A decade on Antarctica might chill you out. Yes.
Oh, zing.
Bad
we need
pun.
A boom, boom.
I love it.
In here.
Yeah, no, I just think, like, somebody asked me on my page, boy, you seem to be defending racists a lot. And I thought, you know what? I don't view my friends as racist because they might have some ideas that I think are stupid or outdated.
Yeah.
I don't think that makes you that. I don't think, and here's a controversial thing right now, everybody that's posting, hey, all lives matter.
Ugh.
It drives me nuts, but they don't understand
they don't
what
get
the
it.
Movement
right.
is about.
Yeah,
right?
They don't. Yeah.
So I don't say, hey, and I see a lot of people saying, well, you're a racist piece of shit. They're not trying to be racist. They just don't understand. They don't understand.
Yeah.
So it's our job, if we can, to try to help them understand.
Well, I told a story one time because I have a pretty multicultural family.
Mm-hmm.
And the first time I was exposed to racism was when I was 14. It took my parents like probably 2 weeks to get it through my head as to what I witnessed.
Oh, yeah.
Because I'd never seen it before. right? So there's a, and it's not that these people haven't seen these people, that they haven't seen racism before, but they've never experienced racism. So they just, it's kind of like, you know, when you're in early on and you get your first girlfriend and you're like, oh, I'm so in love, you know?
Yeah.
And then you look back 10 years later, like, that was not love.
Yeah.
You know, that was hormones.
Yeah. We both loved Cool Ranch Doritos. I thought it was a match made in heaven.
Yeah, exactly. What else do you need, right? That's a good reference. I love those. But yeah, so I kind of look at it. I'm like, okay, so they don't understand it because they truly haven't lived it. It's up to people that have to try to help them understand, and it's up to them to want to understand.
Yeah.
Like, as soon as we start closing our minds off to conversations, that's where we become assholes.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
Absolutely.
You know, you're not an asshole for not understanding. You're an asshole for not being willing to understand.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
Yeah.
So, let's bring up the next post, because I think it gets into assholes as well. This is another one. The world is so confusing to me right now, right? So I thought this was a great post. The Klingons are preparing to fire. Red alert, Captain. And he's like, an act like that could kill a lot of people, but no red alert. I'd rather play it down and not create a panic.
Yeah.
You know, like, that's a perfect... I think, you know, obviously there's holes in every meme, and memes are not to be meant as gospel, but that is a really perfect kind of way of looking at this whole situation.
Yeah.
Right? Like... downplaying something while you know it's going to kill a bunch of your citizens seems insane. Why wouldn't you just say, look, we got a big fight on our hands, let's do this together
and
get it done, like Captain Feminist did, right? I think he did a pretty good job. What do you think through this whole COVID thing?
No, absolutely. That's the one thing I think it shocks me to see people still ripping on him for his response, because I think it was way more level-headed than what we've seen south of the border.
No, I think
he's done a good job during the pandemic. Whether you support him or his party or not, I think we should all be able to agree on that. I think you'd have to be a little, well, people are a little nuts and still want to hate on him for everything.
People definitely are. You can't find Nelson? Are you on your Facebook? You can't find Nelson on Facebook? Did they take you down?
Oh, I don't know, maybe.
M-A-Y-E-R is how you spell his last name. Like the wiener.
Yes.
Isn't the wiener E?
It's spelled the exact same way. It is. Same way. M-A-Y-E-R.
Okay, yeah, that's definitely him.
I love that my cover photo is so misleading. It makes it look like I'm a superstar comic, but I was opening the show for Don Bernstein.
Right,
that's Clayton right there.
Scroll down.
I posted this thing, this podcast thing that we did a while back that
I
hated.
Scroll down a bit. There you go. And so that's him in the middle. But there's got to be a better picture of him. Let's get a better picture of your son.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. Go to photos.
Yeah, look on photos. There'll be a bunch of him sleeping.
Yeah, you put him. Yeah, you always have him on there sleeping all the time. Where is he?
See, I've been mad at him for a while, so I haven't been posting it. It's going to be down a bit.
Yeah, down a bit. Where is he?
I post a lot of crap.
Oh, I thought that was him, but that's
Aquaman.
That's
him right there again from our show, yeah.
There we go. Okay, so let's put it large on the screen. I love it.
Come on. I don't look that much older than him.
Well, not in that one. Wow, that almost looks like Joe Rogan in the middle, to be honest. Doesn't it? Kind of looks like an older Joe Rogan.
Yeah, a little bit.
I was like, wow, did you guys go on the Joe Rogan show? Shit, I should be rolling out the red carpet for you here.
No, that's Mitch Dorge from the Crash Test Dummies.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't think anybody knows what he looks like except for...
except for the lead
Brad
singer.
Roberts. Yeah, that's awesome. He claims huge, eh? How tall is he?
Yeah, 6'5", 6'6", something like that. Yeah, he's a big boy.
That is a big boy.
We were watching the video of... Did you see the video of him falling down the hill when we were outside the Rock and Roll History Museum and Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
No, where is that?
Video. Should throw that up there. There's a video on YouTube. We called it Fatty Go Splatty. Clayton called it that.
Fatty
goes splatty. My favorite video of all time. What happened? I'll set it up. Clayton, we were walking around to the parking lot, and we all walked down this hill outside of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and Clayton's going to go the long way around, and we're shaming him. Like, come on, Clayton's going to take a half hour to walk. Just come down here. It's fine. And then he starts walking, and instantly we just kind of knew something was going to happen. So we put the camera up.
Not on YouTube, but on our screen for people to see. Don't do that one. Yeah, you just screwed up. Ashley just screwed up. Oh. Put it full screen for people to see in OBS. Yeah, instead of the small browser, put a large browser. There we go. Let's see this. play it. You don't need to play it with audio. You need to see it with audio. Is that him at the top of the hill?
That's him at the top of the hill.
Oh, boy.
And I'm saying, well, here's where Clayton dies.
Look at his cape flapping in the wind.
It's brilliant. And then he loses his footing.
Oh, no.
And I tell him, don't run. He had no idea that he was running. He's never done
it before. Oh, no. Oh, my God.
And then, bam.
Into
the concrete. And then the half hour I wanted to save from walking all the way around, we spent waiting for him to get back up again.
Oh, I like that you guys have a little montage.
Oh, yeah. We have the Benny Hill music playing in the background and everything.
Oh, Jesus.
It's great.
Well.
Yeah. That's my son, Clayton.
Yeah, cool. You can pull it off the screen now. Shout out to Clayton, your son.
Yeah, finish editing those videos, Clayton.
Yeah, get your shit together, Clayton.
Every day I'm like, I'm going to fire him. I'm going to contact him and tell him he's done. And then I just can't. He's my friend. I haven't done it yet. We'll see.
Let's talk about, so Clayton physically fell down. Let's talk about a melt. Let's do the meltdown of the year on Twitter. This is so funny. I love it. No, it's the post. You're on the right one. Yes. Okay, you're gonna have to zoom in a bit. So this was Nick Jonas.
Okay, yeah.
On Twitter. So he's going through a bit of a do it in OBS.
Is he the Jonas brother that was in Jumanji?
Was Ashley would know that better than I would. Was that Nick Jonas? Mm-hmm. Oh, you don't know? Oh, what the heck? Okay, so at the top. Okay, you're probably gonna have to do it in Google. Actually, you're probably gonna have to. Yeah, to zoom in on it. That zoomed out. It's at the bottom there. Hit the plus at the bottom. There we go. Oh, look at us go. Technology, it's fine. So this is Nick Jonas. So this is great. You're going to love this. So, okay, guys, there's something that's really been bothering me lately, and I just got to ask. Is it weird that my job is literally just singing about sexy ladies with my brothers? Uh-huh. But, like, let's go tweet for tweet. So do the next one.
Like, instead of going to an office or, like, doing construction, I spend all day writing songs about what I want hot girls to do to me. And I sing those songs with my two older brothers.
Imagine you were hanging out with your family and you were just like, hey, dad, I love to have sex with women. And your dad was like, hell yeah, let's all sing a song about my son getting laid. You'd think that was weird, right?
Yeah. I asked Kevin and Joe how they feel about it, and they just shrugged. Not reassuring.
Is this incest? I feel like you should get the secondary ones because they're way funnier and you'll tell them better. But is this incest? I mean, I know it's not incest, but I don't know. If incest is on a spectrum, is getting paid to dance with your brothers to songs about touching sexy girls that you wrote with your brothers on it? I don't know.
Have you guys ever thought about the Kings of Leon? Of this Kings of Leon? Do you ever wish you were singing Sex on Fire with your friends instead of your family?
I don't know, man. I just don't know. Lots of bands do it, I guess. Oasis. Haim? Who's Haim? Ham?
Haim?
Haim? I don't know.
Did Corey Haim have a band?
I guess, maybe.
On second thought, Haim is sisters. Maybe that makes it okay. Not sure. Wow. All right. That's kind of weird.
Me and my bros had the one song about the time machine, but basically all the other ones are about pretty girls. Should they all have been about time machines? Maybe from here on out, all of our songs will be about something that's normal to discuss with siblings. Cars, yard work, mom and dad, etc.
Honestly, don't know what I would do all day if I weren't singing about sex with my brothers. You should put a comma there. Do not have resume. I'm not on LinkedIn. Basically, no marketable skills except singing about getting laid with immediate family. Ugh.
Whatever. At the end of the day, I guess some jobs are just weird, and this just happens to be mine. Been doing this since I was like 10, so why stop now, I suppose? That's the end, right? Is that the last one? Yeah.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Wow.
That guy was having a crisis of faith that day.
Yeah, I didn't catch that one.
Do you ever have those kind of mixed emotions about comedy, and do you ever write them down?
I don't get on stage and tell dick jokes with my brother, although I think I would. You're singing about songs about banging women, and your brothers are your backup singing or whatever. I mean, you probably talk about sex with your brothers, right?
None of the Jonas Brothers are backups. They're all equal. Okay Nelson?
Besmirching their names. I just disappointed a bunch of Jonas fans. All your Jonas fans are going to write in now and complain. I fucked it up for you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, okay, we have basically the same fan base, just so you know.
I figured as much. Yeah. No, I think, I mean, you talk about these kind of things with your brother, so I guess it's okay. I think it's more weird that he said it would be okay if sisters were doing it.
Yeah.
That was the weird, that's a takeaway for me. It was not weird until he got to that point. Then
oh, really?
Fucking weird.
That's where it got weird for you.
Why is it? Why do you think it's bad for you and your brothers, but it's okay for a bunch of sisters to do it? If you're uncomfortable with the one, shouldn't you be uncomfortable with the other one?
I think one of the most searched videos on Pornhub is threesome with sisters or twins or something.
Oh, yeah.
So I guess that's probably where he's going with that. That, like, for some reason, men think it's... That's okay. I don't know. But then you're like, well, why don't you have sex with your brother? And you're like, what the fuck? You know, like, why would you offend me in such an egregious way?
Yeah, it's gross.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I find it strange. But you know what? I actually, after I saw that tweet, I went and looked at some of their, like, performances.
Yeah.
So there's, like, this girl will walk up. She'll, like, prance up to the front of the stage. And she'll be doing, like, sexy poses. And then the two of the brothers will come up and they'll be touching her and everything. I'm like,
oh, yeah.
Okay, now it's weird.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Especially when their hands, like, touch each, like, they'll, like, high five each other. I'm just like,
oh yeah,
no. I mean, I get it. Some guys want to do an Eiffel Tower, but
they've done it.
It is brothers. So.
This is a confession. This is what's going on here. He's talking about after the show what happens, and that's what really creeps him out.
There's deeper, darker thoughts
deeper.
Here.
I think it goes deeper. Those Jonas Brothers are creepy bastards.
Damn those Jonas Brothers. But you know what? Entertainment's just fucked right now.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you look at everything that's happening in Hollywood and all this stuff with the, you know, Epstein and...
Oh, yeah.
It's like, man, but the crazy thing is I've seen very little proof about most of the stuff going on.
Yeah.
Like, especially Tom Hanks.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And people are like, oh, he's a pedophile. And I'm like, wait, this guy was, like, last year, wasn't he, like, voted the nicest guy ever?
Yeah. Didn't he play Mr. Rogers?
Yeah, like, he's, you know, he's... I've never seen any story before this about him ever, and I tried to look it up. I couldn't really find anything.
Oh yeah, everything's nuts, and he's probably ordering kids off of that Wayfair site too. That's another thing
in
that
the drawers.
I saw. Yeah.
Yeah, like Kramer.
Yeah,
yeah. I thought that was really funny. I was like, nobody's done it yet that I've seen. Nobody's put together a video of like Kramer looking at a screen, and then he orders, and then it's like Wayfair.
Oh yeah,
you know, because he bought that.
Yeah,
do you remember that episode of Seinfeld? Yeah, when he bought the shelves, and then the little Asian guy was in it.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. I'm like, this is
that's
this
perfect.
This is actually Seinfeld was ahead of their time. They're like The Simpsons.
Yeah,
you know, where everybody goes back and looks at episodes, like, well, obviously they're prophets, and they have a time machine.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, no. Natural ways the way society goes.
Yep.
But I think Hollywood's a disaster. And like,
yeah, it's ridiculous.
Singers.
I love the Tom Hanks thing because somebody posted a picture of it was just his jeans were a little ruffled at the bottom and circling it saying, this is an ankle bracelet. That's what's going on here.
Oh, my God. It's like that old guy that the police pushed down and split his head open. Did you see that?
I don't think I saw that.
During one of the BLM protests.
Oh, okay.
And the police pushed him. Like, he's a 70-something-year-old guy.
Okay.
And he goes to, like, reach, and you can't really tell what he's doing. And I think Trump had said that he believed that he was going for a signal scrambler so that the people could kill the cops. Or I don't know. But he's, like, literally this old, frail man.
Yeah.
And he kind of, like, reaches over. He could have been having a spasm in his back. Who knows?
Yeah.
And the cop just pushed him, and his head hits the concrete and blood.
Shit.
You know? And but... people look at it and they're like, well, that's messed up. And then Trump looks at it and he's like, well, obviously the cops are defending themselves. You know, he was about to kill them.
Yeah.
And I'm like, this is so insane the way that people can read into anything.
Wow. Yeah. No, I didn't see that. Some people lost their mind because this guy got pushed down. He was a white guy.
Yeah, he was an old white. Like, we're talking old skin. You know, like the white guy that you picture in your head when you're picturing an old white guy, that was him.
Yeah.
You know? And I'm like,
he didn't even mean to be at the rally.
He's he's probably
looking
like,
for a,
like,
Starbucks or something.
Yeah, he's like, I'm looking for the hospital. Still got his gown on.
Wow.
IV tube running behind him. Yeah, no.
Yeah, people put such a spin on everything. It's a crazy world. The Facebook world, social media world, it's tough to navigate. I have kids that are trying to be on there right now, and it really bothers me because there's so much bullshit out there and so much fighting and so much shaming of each other, and I don't know if I want them to be a part of it.
Yeah, I don't blame you. Like, I think that Nick Jonas tweet thread, that was probably the most woke conscious thing I've seen on the internet in like the last year.
Yeah.
You know, at least he's questioning
his
environment and his life and everything, right?
Yeah.
I feel like most people just don't bother.
How old is that guy? He's got to be like still like early 20s, mid 20s or something.
Nick Jonas, I don't know. You can tell us.
No.
You can Google it. You can find out how old Nick Jonas is.
He's too young for an existential crisis.
You know what's going to suck is that now I'm going to get a bunch of Nick Jonas shit for ads on Facebook and everything.
Oh, yeah.
How old is He's like, oh, okay, he's like 30.
30? Oh, well, shit, it's all downhill then. Yeah.
We're like, is he 30? Oh, okay. All right. Okay. So he's not even 30 yet?
Yeah, wow. Yeah. Too young to be breaking down like that.
I guess he was after... Was he after... Okay, so Jonas Brothers. He was after Hanson and all that, right?
After Hanson, yeah.
Yeah, and Umbop and all that. Yeah. By the way, I don't give a shit who you are. You may have not liked Umbop when it came out.
Uh-huh.
But I don't care if you're Ice Cube. You hear that shit right now, oh, and that gets you going.
Your feet, yeah.
Especially in your car.
Yeah.
You're like just... Sunroof hits, and you're like, yeah, and you're singing along.
Now, Mbop, was that about sex with women? Were those guys doing the same thing?
Huh, I don't
That's
know.
What I'm wondering.
That's now. Interesting. Mbop lyrics. Let's do it, Ashley.
Check this out.
We're not singing it, but we will look at them.
I think all I can sing is Mbop.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Yeah,
are there lyrics?
I actually don't know what the lyrics are. It's like when they used to allow Next Too Close be played at school dances,
yeah.
And then the principals and teachers found out what it was about.
Yeah.
They're like, whoa, what the fuck?
I love they still play YMCA, which is a wicked anthem for bum sex. And the kids' school dances, the village people. Oh, yeah, that's what the YMCA was
YMCA
all about.
YMCA was about
that
butt
was
sex?
That was the hangout back in the day. That's where people would have to go because homosexuality was a lot more hidden. They had to be to keep safe. And
yeah.
So a lot of the meetups were at YMCA and the steam rooms and the saunas and stuff like
is
that.
Is this substantiated
I'm not,
or
I'm
is
not
this
even
gossip?
Go ahead and Google it. This is real shit.
Okay, well, we're on Moombop. We're on Moombop first.
And
so
that's YMCA was an anthem for gay sex and gay people, which I think is fucking great because they play at kids' school dances and everybody's out there doing the YMCA.
Wow.
I love it.
I had no idea. Okay, Moombop. So what is this? What are we looking at? Okay.
See, relationships. Okay,
in
see?
In this life, only one or two will last. You go through all the pain and strife. God, uh-huh. This is a depressing fucking song.
I think the single came with a free razor blade.
Then you turn your back and then gone
so
fast.
Fast.
Oh, yeah. And they're gone so fast. Yeah. Well, can you repeat yourself a couple more times?
Hold on the ones who really care.
In the end, they'll be the ones there. The only ones there.
Oh, when you get old and start losing your hair, these guys are awesome lyricists.
Can you
this
tell me
who will
care? Still care?
And then say it twice.
Yeah, then say it
so
twice.
Nice. Oh, care.
So this is actually a super depressing song about a guy that, like,
it's about sexy. Plant a seed, plant a flower. What is that getting at?
Plant a
That's
rose.
That's innuendo right there.
Oh, you went up.
Dirty.
We're examining Mbop. You can't fuck up right now, Ashley, okay? plant a seed, plant a flower, plant a rose. You can plant any one of those. Keep planting to find out which one grows. It's a secret no one knows. Oh, no one knows.
See?
What?
This is some sexual Wayfair shit going on. I knew it.
They were selling
they
on
were
Wayfair
dirty.
Before Wayfair was Wayfair.
Probably.
Holy shit. I bet you they're selling the...
We just busted Hanson. We know what they're up to now.
God, this song is actually kind of ruined a little bit for me.
Yeah. Well, this, it's just Mbop.
Is this like emos before emos? I don't know what's going on here. Can you tell me? No, you can't because you don't know. Can you tell? Oh, okay. That's just repeating itself over and over again. Mbop, dubba.
That's it. That's it.
What the hell is that song even? So the song is about a guy who's depressed, who can't get girls.
Can't get a girl.
And then he's not going
to. He wants to keep her.
Yeah, and then he wants to plant her his seed.
Oh, he's going to bury her in his backyard.
He's going to Mbop her.
Twisted song. That's dark.
Yeah.
It's dark. I didn't realize.
It was dark, so I'm not endorsing the fist pump of the sunroof.
I'm
going to
have to turn the station whenever they play it now.
You listen to radio?
Once in a while, I do.
Holy shit. What's that like?
I'm
commercials
old,
and everything.
I have to listen to commercials. It's weird. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think I've heard a commercial in my music in like 15 years.
Yeah.
I feel like it's been a long time. So you listen to radio.
Oh, yeah, cruise to the dial, yeah. Yeah, I throw it on the XM satellite once in a while. I do the Aussie Boneyard and that kind of thing.
For the millennials amongst us, cruising through the dial was
That's
cool
right.
dialect for looking at the different radio stations. I'm just making sure, Ashley. You never know. Okay, now we have to look up that YMCA thing because we cannot have unsubstantiated gossip on this show. We can't be that. So what does YMCA mean? What does the song YMCA mean?
Yes.
A welfare movement.
That's just actual YMCA. You have to search village people in there.
Yeah, or the, what does song. The song, the YMCA song mean? Let's look this up. I'm so curious to see. Young Men's Christian Association. What? That's what it stood for?
Yeah.
That's what YMCA stands for?
Yep. Young Men's Christian Association.
Huh. Nothing about fitness. Okay, let's see here. Tongue-in-cheek to gay culture. The YMCA is still an organization that offers single-room occupancy for... Wow, okay. Interesting. What is that? I've never seen
that. It became a place where homosexuals could arrive into the city and not be immediately homeless. It also became a major source of hookups, drug contacts, acting roles, and other jobs.
So we should be singing G-R-I-N-D-R. It doesn't quite roll off the tongue as well.
No, not as well.
But it's similar. Interesting.
Yeah. So shit, I love when they play that at little kids' school dances. You got little tiny kids with their moms out there having no idea that they're dancing around celebrating gay culture, which I think is great. Play it at every kid's school dance.
You know what? I went to, I don't know if you remember the famous Trump rally when he got to Florida and he got out on stage like, we could really use some global warming here. I'm pretty sure that they played YMCA at his rally.
Oh, yeah?
And
okay.
I'm pretty sure all those people were doing it and loving it.
Yeah, yeah.
But that's, so they didn't take the time to understand it, which is fine. It's a song. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I didn't know until right now. Mm-hmm. I'm 25 for life, and I had no idea. So I've lived at least 25 years not knowing this knowledge. But so I guess, why can't we do this with comedy then? Why can't we just accept that, like, I don't know. Like, why do we have to jump on everything? Like, now, oh, we're screwed now. You told them that YMCA is about this, so YMCA is going to be canceled.
Yeah.
But, like, I guess, because there's a lot of songs that have hidden meanings, you know, so why don't people jump on those? Why do they got to jump on comedians?
I think they're jumping on everything these days.
Yeah, they everything's really getting it?
Everything's getting it, and it's ridiculous. Comedy's just an easy one because there's so many weak comedians out there that are easy fodder for this, right? But then they go after other big-name comics who, you know, it comes down to a difference of opinion a lot of times, right? People aren't going to agree with you, and they don't have to. That's the thing that drives me nuts. If I'm talking with somebody who identifies as a white supremacist and they're not being ignorant to me, they're not out hurting people, they just have what I would consider a fucked-up view, and we have a discussion about it and we go different ways, that's actually okay in this world. Not okay that, you know, but you know, you know what I mean? It's okay to not agree with people.
Yeah.
I think we've lost that. We've built these social media fucking silos where we tell you, if you don't agree with me on something, unfriend me. So I'm never faced with a differing opinion. Everything around me confirms my own belief system.
Big old echo chamber.
Absolutely. And, you know, then you try to shut down other people that aren't agreeing with you or don't think the same way as you. And sometimes I think it gets pretty damn malicious.
It does. Like, I definitely, there's lots of times where I've said on Facebook, because that's where all my big debates happen. I actually had a blog where a lot of my debates would happen, but since I got doxxed several times and I got death threats in the mail, I took it anonymous. So I don't really do anything over there, but I'll debate on my Facebook and I'll say, I am well open to changing my mind.
Mm-hmm.
Just show me something that has tangible proof.
Yeah.
And I'll look at it. And if I think, and if it's proof, like real proof, like actual substantiated proof, then I will say I was wrong. I'll amend my worldview.
Yeah.
Like, to be honest, I really didn't understand LGBTQA+. Am I saying that right? Culture. I didn't really get that culture when I was younger because I wasn't really exposed to it.
Yeah.
And the one experience I had with a gay man was not positive.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, I didn't really get the whole culture. I didn't get the pride. I was like, or the pride parade, the pride. I didn't get the pride parade because I was like, why is everybody like dancing and like naked? And like, I'm like, there's no straight parade, when I was like 19 or something. And then I delved into it
because
one of my good friends came out and I was like, oh. And he's like, I came to you because I wasn't too sure how you'd react.
Oh, okay.
And I was like, oh, I feel shitty about that. Sorry.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, that was not my intent. And then I saw a culture through his experiences. And I was like, what the hell are we all just arguing about this for?
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
My buddy has no interest in trying to stop me from being straight or anything.
Yeah, yeah.
Why are we trying to stop him from being gay?
Yeah.
You know, it's crazy. And I think Black Lives Matter was able to pick up because I think LGBTQA+ has come a long way in the last 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, like, you can go anywhere 5 years ago without seeing something about it and the rights and, you know, marriage and all that. And so I think it's now time to, like, deal with this subject.
Yeah.
You know, obviously it's been long overdue, but I think that's why we're hearing a lot about it now. And I don't understand why people can't just calm the fuck down and just, like, be like, does it affect me? Does it hurt my neighbor? Does it hurt my kids?
Yeah.
No. All right.
Yeah.
And that's where the COVID debate drives me nuts because, motherfucker, you not masking up, you coming in like touching and spitting on me, that fucks me up.
Yeah.
That can actually mess up the whole.
Yeah.
Right? But it can't mess up the whole. If I see someone online that's like, fuck the gays and don't wear a mask, I'm like, you're a true piece of shit human being.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you're picking the wrong causes here.
And I'll
try to talk to them.
You can't reason with them. Like you were saying that, you know, does it really affect you? That's my argument, too. How does this impact you, what somebody else is doing in their bedroom, their personal life? How does it affect you who somebody else loves? Like, fuck you for trying to interrupt and interfere with that. But they really do think this affects them. It's going to corrupt their children. It's going to, you know, it's going to ruin society in their minds. So,
because a bunch of people being happy instead of being miserable and killing themselves because nobody will accept them.
Yeah.
So much worse for society.
Oh, yeah. Like, you don't want your kids seeing happy couples.
Yeah, exactly. And like, I have, let me think, off the top of my head, I have four married friends who are gay.
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you. Their marriages are working out a lot better than a lot of my single friends' marriages, you know? I think that they just, I don't know what it is. I think that they have a better understanding of each other. Maybe they take more. I honestly don't know what it is.
Yeah.
But they're happy. They're really actually happy.
Yeah.
How is that a bad role model for your kids?
I was going to say, isn't that what we should be modeling, right, in all relationships?
Yeah.
Yeah, gay marriage ruins the sanctity of marriage, says a guy who's fucking cheating on his wife. And he
like that seriously. Pastor, right? That pastor was talking, he's like, It's evil to be gay, and then they found out he was like sleeping with like every single woman in his congregation.
Yeah,
I'm like, what's that? Yeah, okay, all right.
Yeah, we do this every time.
We go over. What else do we got here? Oh, this is you have to relate to this as a comedian. This one.
Okay.
The mini heartbreak when you're telling a story but nobody is listening, so you just stop in the middle.
I just keep going, man.
Do you?
I don't care. That's like being on stage and nobody's listening. Hey, man, I set up this joke. I'm finishing the damn thing.
That's fair.
I don't care.
But I truly relate to this tweet.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and I see it sometimes. Like, I in my office, which is next door, we got a rather large group of people. And sometimes, you know, I have a couple louder staff members. And one of them is actually going to be on. You know, people will be telling a story. So, you know, Ashley will be like, yeah, you know, somebody will say, hey, Ashley, what did you do this weekend? And she'll be like, well, you know, this weekend I went snowboarding and then I went skydiving. And then this one of the staff members will be like, yeah, and I did this. And like, you won't even let her finish.
Oh,
you know? And it's like, oh, you just feel that.
I've felt it before. I have. On stage, I plow through it, but I felt it in real life too. A lot of people, I learned this. I took a course called Interpersonal Communication in University. And what we learned is, people don't talk to each other. You're just waiting for them to shut up so you can say what you have to say. So as soon as Ashley starts telling her snowboarding story, it cues something in my brain that I did.
Yeah.
And now I'm like, okay, when can I jump in with my shut up this boring shit story? I got to share my cool fucking thing that I did, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, I guess
it's
people
crazy.
Do that a lot. I think I've probably done it in the past.
Well, I'm guilty of it. I took this course and I nailed it, and I'm still an asshole sometimes in conversation.
But you at least try.
I try. I try to do better. Sometimes I can.
Yeah.
Other times it's like we all value what we have to say. That's the thing on Facebook. Everybody thinks their opinion matters so damn much.
Yeah.
And really, you know what? It doesn't. We can all learn from each other. And we don't always have to agree.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. No, I have tried, you know, and I noticed when I podcast that I listen a lot more in real life because I get it out of my system. You know, we're going back and forth, crazy banter. I'm just tired. I don't want to talk to anybody after I do 3 hours of these,
right?
Yeah. So people tell me stories and I don't enter, and they're like, are you still awake? I'm like, I'm just listening.
Yeah.
I'm just taking it in,
man.
Yeah, exactly. Jinx, you owe me a Coke. Isn't that something guys and girls only say? Do you guys say that to each other? Jinx, you owe me a Coke?
I mean, I'm old. We do it. I don't know. Do people still do it? Does Ashley know what the hell we're talking about right now?
Do you know?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Okay.
So would you say it to a guy and would a guy say it to you? And would you say it to a girl and would a girl say it to you? Okay. All right.
All right.
I'm just trying to get the social cues down. It's a very confusing time to be alive.
Is it normally a flirty thing?
I thought it was a flirty thing. Every time I've seen it done in a movie, always between
true.
Like
that
a guy
true,
is trying
yeah.
to get with a girl or a girl's trying to get with a guy. Oh, okay. Okay, all right.
Yeah.
All right,
I would say it to anyone as well, but I do recognize what you're saying. It is generally, I've never thought of it before, it is generally a flirty thing, so maybe I've been flirting with those dudes I've been doing all these years. I have no idea what get me a Coke meant, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
I got to stop telling my buddies to come Netflix and chill with me now.
Yes, please stop that right now. I mean, unless you're tired of having kids.
I mean, I'm old. I think chill just means chill, right? When did this change?
Yeah, it did change. I remember Michelle Obama put up a tweet one time, and she was like, just going to Netflix and chill tonight. Everyone's like, oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. And she's like, what? Like, that's actually what we're going to do. Our kids are going to, you know, come, you know, we're going to watch Netflix, you know? And she had no idea.
Yeah.
It was great.
That's awesome.
And she's a pretty, like, she's a pretty hip person, so it was funny that she did that. What else do we got? Let's round this out. This is so timely for right now. You can read this one out. I love this one.
Any zombie movie that doesn't have hordes of people running towards the zombies to deliberately get bitten because they're convinced it's a liberal hoax is going to look pretty unrealistic now. Yes, absolutely.
I can't wait for that movie.
That's awesome. I like this one.
What are we looking at? Casey Explosion? What? What is that? Oh, it's a sexy cow. Well, cows can be sexy, I guess. Are you anti-cow? Are you anti-cows getting it on in the field, Ashley?
We're going to have to cancel Ashley.
Yeah, we got to cancel Ashley because she's trying to cancel cows.
Or we got to be concerned cows. Because Jesus. You said cows can be sexy and earlier you asked for a blow-up sheep.
I can see how that would be misconstrued.
Might be misinterpreted.
We're going to abandon the big sheep idea, okay? You can bring your Serta sheep and leave it on that side of the table so I don't get tempted. But yeah, no, I totally think I want to see this movie.
Yeah, I'd watch that.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. And actually, that's probably a good way to like weed everybody out.
Yeah.
Let's get a real zombie. I remember when COVID first came out, everybody was worried it was a zombie apocalypse.
Yeah.
Like, come on. It's a big reach.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a really big reach.
Yeah.
Bath salts? Maybe bath salts have been weaponized. I guess
it's the 5G towers, though. That's what
the 5G towers. There was a guy outside of my building during COVID, during the lockdown, when there was no traffic and no foot traffic at all.
Yeah.
And he had a big sign. He's like, the 5G towers are killing us. I'm like, who are you talking to right now? There's nobody here. You know, I guess that was the only forum he could get.
That's awesome.
A forum of no. So you're doing the show.
I am, yes. I'm doing this show with Clayton After Dark. We've actually filmed almost all of our interviews. We have to film a couple more monologues because we shut it down. I decided when the cases started going back up in Manitoba and the social distancing at the venue, it wasn't happening. So I thought I'm going to make the executive decision to just shut this down and stop filming live. Even though we were doing quite well, we were at capacity for our second show and we were probably going to have to turn people away for the third show. But at the same time, this isn't the time for that. So I thought, as much as it sucks and it's going to kill our momentum going into this, I need to do it because I think it's the right thing to do right now. So I'm going to shut down the live tapings. But we continue to do interviews, and we filmed on a closed set. We have everything together almost. We just need that one person to do the editing, and then we're good to go. In the meantime, there is stuff online. I think there's YouTube After Dark, Winnipeg Night. Late night talk show, it might be called. I have no idea.
Okay.
This is what Clayton does. I just show up and try to be funny. He has to do all that other shit.
Fair enough.
He's not doing his job. So
fair enough.
I'm going to choke
Clayton.
That's what's going to happen.
You're not allowed to beat your children, though.
I won't, but Clayton's not my kid, so I can beat the shit out of him.
All right. Yeah. Keep forgetting. Okay. And then I guess you're not doing any shows right now.
Not right now.
Tune into your Facebook for your comedy?
Yeah. I have there's that Brandon, the Western Manitoba tour was canceled and then it was rescheduled for October and then Brandon got shut down again. So now everything's off the table, but we are going to eventually do that. So there will be a tour coming up. I can't say when right now. If people want to follow me on social media, follow me on Facebook. I'm old. I'm on that one. Eventually there'll be news, hopefully. In the meantime,
are you on Instagram as well?
I am. I don't really use it. I'm on all these things. My kids put me on Snapchat. I don't touch that thing. I'm really old. I got a Hotmail account and Facebook. That's it.
Hotmail.
And I'm told I'm old as shit because of those two things. I'm surprised I don't have a flip phone still.
Yeah, me too. What is that?
This is Huawei.
Oh, you brought that into our place?
I did, yeah. It's got 5G
in it. How dare you not leave that in your car?
No, it's terrible.
You got a Huawei too? Oh, my God. I'm surrounded by Chinese Intel.
Yeah, it comes from China.
Yes, it does.
I love it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah? You should take some dick pics and send it to the guy that's looking at your phone every night.
You know, I'm going to start sending them to Clayton if he doesn't edit my videos. I'm going to just bombard him constantly.
You might be curious. I think somebody needs to do this. Somebody needs to take nightly dick pics and write something on it. And eventually somebody's going to say something in Huawei. Be like, I was looking at these dick pics and they're constantly telling me to go fuck myself and shit. Like, what am I supposed to do?
Yeah.
This is how we uncover the truth.
That's how we figured out. Yeah. I'm not going to volunteer to be that guy.
No? Okay, no. Fine. Yeah. All right. No. Well, we'll just get... I have a few candidates in mind. We'll get this done. We'll figure out if Huawei is truly spying on
it
us.
It is not going to be hard to find a guy that wants to take dick pics. Ask any woman that's on online dating. She can refer you to dozens.
I'm going to tell you, in a few episodes, you're going to want to watch. So I have an episode coming up with They do. It's these two women that do a podcast about basically sex and relationships and all that. And we're going to be covering a few subjects. One, is he doing it right?
Yeah.
And two, what's happened to dating and relationships and everything. But the big thing is we're going to be pulling up. We're going to be a special edition. It's going to be what men post, the shit men post.
Oh, okay.
So, and we're real. And I actually, I don't know if you saw my status on earlier this week, but I asked women to send me their Tinder conversations.
Yeah, saw that, yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
My mind, honestly, like I actually closed out sometimes because I was so disturbed by what I was seeing.
It makes you ashamed. I pranked a friend of mine. I'm a bad person. There's no denying it. I pranked a friend of mine and I made an undercover account on Plenty of Fish. I was a woman on Plenty of Fish and I was messaging him being a dick for this little show that we used to do called the Nelson, Mark, and Kyle Show.
Okay.
And anyway.
Very original name, by the way.
While I was on POF, I got bombarded with other messages from other dudes, and it made me ashamed to be a man. It really did. It was terrible.
Terrifying.
The game some of these guys had was absolutely weak and so transparent and see-through. Dudes were sending me messages asking for nude pictures, and they got, like, you could see in his picture, his fiance, he's recently engaged. Like, wow, you're a total piece of shit. I can't believe this. And I got about a dozen dick pics from people that I had never even said
unsolicited.
Hello to.
Yeah, unsolicited.
Never even said hello. This is their high.
I mean, I'm going to say this on that podcast too, but guys, no woman has ever been like, you know what I need today? An unsolicited dick pic in my inbox. It has never been a thing. Yeah. Ashley is nodding her head.
Yeah.
So let's
jeez, what would really cheer me up right now?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm feeling a little sick today. Maybe if I could just get a dick pic, I'd feel better.
Yeah.
You know, I'm a little depressed today.
I got a dick pic sent to me once. It was sent to me, an unsolicited dick pic. A guy had added me after a show. He really enjoyed my comedy, and I was chatting with him because I'm friendly with everybody, and he was very flirtatious. I was like, hey, cool, I appreciate it. That's not who I am, but thank you. I mean,
that's a compliment.
And then I continued talking to him, and I was friendly with him like I am with everybody. And one day out of the blue, bam, he just sends me his dick pic. And I'm sitting there like, wow, I don't even know what to say to that. I'm like, wow, pretty solid looking dong, bro. Like, I don't know what to say. Like, I'm still not fucking interested.
Did he respond to it?
No. Sorry. Yeah, I didn't mean to send that. Yeah, you did.
Mean
yeah,
to
you
send
did.
That? Man, I'm gonna share a secret right now of the internet. Nobody has ever sent a picture over Messenger and not meant to send it.
Yeah.
There's like 15 different buttons you have to press to actually pull that off.
Yeah, you meant to execute this.
Man, this went south quick.
Yeah, we ended on dick pics. Didn't you say that we started with COVID and ended up on like dick pics and sex?
We're pretty much on par with the way that communication should be these days. Awesome. So, only Facebook, that's it?
Facebook that I use, so you can find me on that. And like I said, the tour is going to be coming up. We're doing this show after dark. I have a bunch of projects up in the air. Nothing that's solidified yet, so we'll see what happens.
Cool.
Hopefully this after dark thing, we'll get more episodes up right away.
Yeah, let's hope. Clayton, get your shit together, bitch.
That's right, Clayton.
Motherfucker.
I'm going to push you down another hill.
All right, and that is it for Shit People Post. This was with Nelson Mayer, comedian extraordinaire. And I think the next episode is going to be with Tyler Tynes, who is a former rap superstar. He wanted to live large, and then he went into insurance. So we got Ice Cube, and then we got Tyler Tynes. I think it was a good first episode.
Yeah, it was awesome. Thanks
for coming,
having
dude.
Me, man. Really
I think I'm just going to every show I ever do for the rest of my life, you're going to be on the first episode.
Okay, deal.
Yeah, we're good.
Right on, man.
All right. Unless you die of old age before that we get there, then fuck it. Whatever.
Or I get shot at drive-by.
we'll get Clayton to come on.
Okay.
Because he's, what, 18, 19?
He's old enough. He can honor his father. We'll finish an episode.
Come on the episode and be like, my dad's a piece of shit. And we came full circle.
That's right.
We'll talk to you guys later.